Hola amigos, Ghost here, and today we're continuing our Let's Play of Jedi Outcast, and today could be potentially the final episode, as we're getting closer to Desann, and closer to saving the Jedi Academy from his, grasp. So, let's get to it. Holy shit. I think I have to help them out. But it seems like they got him taken care of, Jesus. Got him. There, see, I helped. Why are you looking at me like that? We're friendly, right? Yeah, we're friendly. I hope. Okay, we can go through there. We gotta go through here. Oh, shit! These Jedi are fucking beasts, bro. They're just kicking these guys' ass. Oh no, it's one of these. He's gonna kick our asses, isn't he? Force speed. No! Yeah, let's gang up on them. Come at us. No shit, they're using the force. Okay, I just got bodied by three of them. Alright, third time. Third time's the charm. Let's go. Oh shit, I forgot I was using... Oh damn, they bodied him so hard! They body these people so hard. There we go. There we go. Bruh, I don't even have to fight these guys no more. These AI are fucking boss at this. Like, damn. Here we go.
We must not fail.
Ow. Here we go. And looks like that's the end of this level. I think we're approaching the end. This next level, we're probably going to encounter Desann. And it looks like is this part of the original trial area we were in? It looks like it. Oh, you can break through these. What the hell? Oh, whoa. He's fucking with us. He's generally fucking with us while we're trying to reach him. How is this a dead end? What? This can't be a dead end. What the fuck? What? Is this bullshit? Okay, I thought that was the end of it. Shit. Okay, I figured it out. I have to, do that. To the flames. Bam. Oh! Oh! I didn't see that. I didn't see that fourth one. Damn it. Okay. Boop. And then, boop. What? How fast do they... Do I have to, like, use my force speed or something? Boop. And then force push. That should have done that. And then that one. Come on. And then go. Okay. Oh, what the fuck? It's fucking with us. Let's go this way. That's a lot of fire. I don't think I could... Yeah, I'm not gonna go that way. So let's go to the other one. Let's go to the right. This leads to a... No! Really? Okay, the right one's to death. The left one is to some fire that I don't think I can get across. So I think we have to go straight. Let's go straight. What? That's us.
Stand and face me, Katarn.
Oh, I see. It's a trick. It makes us think he's right behind us. Ha ha, clever. And that's the death trap, so we have to go down here. Which is still covered in fire. Which I don't like. Can I break? Wait. Yes, I can! Which does that? Yep. I was right. And it looks like there's nowhere else to go, so we go down. Bam. So that one leads to nowhere. Both of these lead to the same one. Can't push them any further. Huh. Wait, pull. Can I pull you? No, I can't. Really? Really, I can't pull any of those? Then what the what am I supposed to do then? If I can't pull you... What the fuck? Don't tell me I have to restart to figure this out. Don't tell me. You know, I'm starting to think I'm blind. I didn't see that at all. And that one pushes this one to... Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah, force speed is probably being necessary for this. Okay, I made it this far. There we go. There we go.
Son.
On the contrary, thanks to you, the weakling Jedi who scorned me will soon be erased from history, replaced by a new race of warriors. Strong warriors, warriors who know that the Force is not a shield to protect the useless, but is in reality a weapon to empower the worthy.
None of that's gonna happen to Son. Most of your shadow troopers are being mopped up by real Jedi. Ones who've been trained to use the Force. The rest blew up with your ship.
What a pathetic ruse. Desann to Fayar. Admiral? Admiral! Admiral Fayar, I order you to come in at once. I was wrong about you, Katarn. Your failure as a Jedi hasn't weakened you. It's only made you stronger. Come. Join me. You know in your heart that you'll never truly be one of them.
Maybe, maybe not. But I know I won't be alone. How about you, Desann? Even now, after all this pain, it's not too late. Come, join us.
You sweet fool!
Ha! Let's go! Let's get it! I wonder what these... I can press those. Can I not? I'm pushing that. Oi! He's staying down there, which I don't like. No, I think I have to pull them. Yeah, I have to pull it. Alright. Oh! I think that thing, that whatever that red beam thing is. Oh, he's coming towards me. Oh no, I think he's become invincible or something. He's glowing. He is glowing.
Save your strength.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to try to get him to come over here. Hoi. Come at me. Where'd he go? Shit, where'd he go? There he is. You know what? Yeah, it's time to deploy some stuff on you, motherfucker. Did he just break them all? He just broke them all. What? Can you stop pushing me? What? What the fuck? Aha! I'm invincible to you now. Come at me, dog. Oh no. I've been a fool. Force heal. Force heal again. Huh. Do I have back? I guess I do. Oh no! It's not what I wanted to use, but okay. Jesus Christ, Bucko! No! No! Okay, I'm dead. Fuck. Alright, here we go, here we go. Shit. Pool. Grab that. So I think that red beams give you like temporary invincibility. And I need them to come over here before I activate it completely. He's coming over here. That's good. Come on, give me the red beam. Yes, invulnerability. And now, make it slow-mo. I'm gonna kick your ass now. Are you kidding me? No way! No way!
The Force will betray you to me.
Alright, let him come to me first. Come on. Come on. Come on, you giant ass dinosaur. Oversized fucking lizard. Come here. Come on.
Jedi run from battle? Run, Katarn!
Come at me then, dog. Come at me.
Yep.
Ah, that feels good. Come here, buddy. You were talking all that shit. How about you come over here? Let me give you some powerful strikes, too, while I'm at it. Okay, now I'm not invincible anymore.
Run, Katarn.
I am going to run because fuck you, that's why. Oh, you know, I'm just stalling. Because I definitely don't have the health to fight you full on, you know. Just stalling. When the fuck is that red laser gonna get back on?
What a pathetic attempt. Dare to push me.
Bro, what? Come on. This overgrown lizard is so powerful for no fucking reason. Come on. Okay, pull that one. Make sure that is that. Oh, I fell short. That should make the lizard want to come towards me. Hopefully. Yep. Make sure I have 4 speeds set up. Strong, and then do force.
Dare to push me.
Yes, I dare. My invincibility wore off a little bit quicker than I thought, so I might run away. No, stop it! Come on, how is there no blocking to that? Okay, now I have no lightsaber, fuck you. Run away! I can't counter him! With the lightning, I can't counter. I fucking can't counter lightning. Where the fuck you go? Ah, shit, I lost him. Please, Red Laser, show back up. I need you one more time. I don't have the strength or the health to continue fighting without you. Yes! Force speed! Give me invulnerability! Thank you! There you go, you fucking bastard!
Kyle, Jan.
Someday you're gonna have to teach me how to do that.
Thanks for taking care of the Raven's Claw.
It was the least I could do for the pair of mercenaries who saved the Jedi Academy. I know you've probably heard this before, but the New Republic is forever in your debt.
You should have known it would take a failed Jedi to take out another failed Jedi.
Kyle, you were never a failure.
Luke,
I know. I'll be happy to hold your lightsaber for safekeeping.
No. I think I'll keep it.
Ha! I knew it! Lando owes me 5 credits.
Are you sure this is what you want, Kyle?
Look, I'm not saying I'm ready to join the Academy or anything like that. I mean, before I do anything, I figure that Jan and I have earned a long vacation on the beaches of Spira. And after that, well...
After that, we'll see.
Yeah.
Take your time, Kyle. We'll still be here when you're ready.
Thanks, and may the Force be with you, Luke.
He said the thing! He said it! He finally said it! Oh, Jesus. Man, I gotta say, that was a pretty fun game overall. I think if I would give it a rating right now, I would probably give it around 8 out of 10. It was a pretty decent game. It's a way above average. It's a very good game in terms of how it was created and what it's meant to be like. From what I've heard, the other games that are similar to this one are just as good, if not better, but I guess a little bit of overall review. The story was pretty cool, in my opinion. It was very interesting. Of course, I like the characters. I like how we met Lando and were able to meet Luke, and how we... this is my first true introduction to Kyle Katarn, and I could tell he's a badass. I already knew he was a badass, even though I didn't know too much about him previously. It was just cool to kind of see another kind of story from Legends that no longer is part of the Disney canon and all that. In terms of the gameplay, the lightsaber combat is pretty fun. Probably the best thing about this game. The gunplay, pretty decent. There's a few guns that are much more favorable than others, and some are much more circumstantial in their use. Like, certain guns I've used maybe once or twice throughout this entire Let's Play. The Force abilities are all freaking cool, and it's cool that even we get some sort of dark side abilities like Force Lightning, even though for at least I think Luke Skywalker, Kyle Katarn, and a few other Jedi of this era use it without being dark side users, which... it's kind of cool because in the newer canon, they make it seem like you have to be a dark side user to use Force Lightning, which I feel like shouldn't be 100% the case, because I know one Jedi in the new canon can do Force Lightning, or a version of Force Lightning, I guess. But yeah, the gunplay, the lightsaber play, the Force abilities are all pretty good, awesome. I love the little descriptions and how they slowly upgrade over time. The enemies that you fight, most of them were pretty cool. I like how we fought like 4 different types of dark side users, besides like the main 2 dark side users we fought as boss battles, basically. But except for, I kind of hated the freaking black armored lightsaber dudes, since they were hard as a motherfucker to kill half the time. Most of the common enemies were pretty easy. I hate those spider creature things in that one mine level. I hate the snipers in that one level. I forgot what the other troop is called, but there was a third troop besides the black armored lightsaber dude that I hated as well, that I just can't remember the name of right now. But for the most part, they were all unique, all had used different weapons and made me have to use different tactics to defeat some of them. Eventually later on, of course, once I got my lightsaber and once I started knowing how to use it pretty well, I didn't really use the lightsaber too much. I mean, I didn't use much of the other weapons and tactics. I used mostly the lightsaber and Force abilities, which I think is what you're supposed to do. But then again, you also have the ability to just straight up run and gun all the time if you want to, which is a cool thing. The platforming for the most part was fun. There was a few times where I hated it only because of the level design, which made me just like, I won't say angry, but just like frustrated a little bit. Certain levels were pretty cool, while others were, like I said, I didn't really like. That one Yavin Swamp level I hated. There was one level early on in the game that I just didn't know what the hell I was doing. But there was a pretty decent mix of levels, and I liked some of them. I think one of my favorites was definitely the Jedi training one. It was very short and very simplistic, but it just oozes that Jedi training, Jedi type stuff that you don't really see in these kinds of games all the time. When it comes to, let me think of what I was trying to say after that point. The way that the levels play out, like how you, the directions, good and bad. Certain levels, yeah, you know what you have to do for the most part and you can get through them pretty easily. But then there's other parts where it's like, where the fuck am I gonna go? Where am I supposed to go? And it's like other times you have to do things that you wouldn't think you have to do to progress in the level. Like the Yavin Swamp level, for example, I had to go underneath the water right there to progress. Or early on during the first section of the game, I had to destroy basically this oven-like thing for the mining material. And then I had to climb on top of the mining material to jump into a mine area. It's like certain things that you wouldn't know what you're supposed to do unless you looked up a guide and such. And that's why I had to end up doing for some of those things. And like I think I said in the previous episode, I might link his the channel's Let's Play in the description. If any of you guys ever play this game and you get lost, you could either use me or his Let's Play as an example. So I probably will link his channel or his playlist in the description of every video once I get around to it, just because he helped me out when... Oh, that's kind of cool. That little thing right there is kind of cool. Oh, we're back to the main screen. But since he kind of helped me out without even knowing it, I feel like I have to at least call a shout out him in one way. I forgot his name, his channel name at the moment, but I'll probably leave a comment for this episode and probably the first episode and maybe every like episode 1, 5, 10, and then this episode to just say, oh yeah, check out this dude's channel. His Let's Play helped me out when I couldn't figure out certain things or how to progress in certain levels and such. But besides that, it's around an 8 out of 10 for me. It's a pretty fun game overall. I wouldn't say I highly recommend it, but if you enjoy Star Wars, you enjoy, lightsaber combat, if you enjoy this types of games, try it out. I recommend it. It's a pretty fun game. It's a decently sized one, I think, at least for me, because of how long it took me to figure out certain levels and because of how many times I died. It's probably around 6 to 8 hours of gameplay on normal difficulty. It's probably lower, less than 6 hours in Padawan difficulty, and it's probably longer for Jedi Knight and Jedi Master, since you have to be more experienced with the combat and the platforming and the mechanics to probably succeed in those levels. But yeah, I think that's about it. If there's anything else I want to mention in the review that I don't mention right now, I'll probably leave a comment, another comment, or leave it in the description. But yeah, hopefully you all enjoyed today's episode and the series as a whole. I certainly did. Until next time, this is Ghost, signing out.